So good morning, students. Myself Vivek Sayani, physics teacher. So today we will discuss about the phenomena of the refraction of light. So refraction is a phenomena in which the light changes its path as it goes from one medium to another. So dear students, let's understand the topic by doing some interesting activities, amazing activities. So let's come, we will start with the top activities. So see here, so let's see the first activity. So this is a glass of water, and suppose I have just one glass rod, I've just put in this. So you see carefully, so glass rod will appear to be bent. So this is again the phenomena of refraction of light. So light is going from air to water. Let's also have one more activity. I have one coin. This is again one glass of water. So I just put up the coin in the water. So if you look at this coin, it will seem to be bigger. So again, this is one more activity related to the refraction of light. So dear student, let's do one more activity. Just I have one coin. I just get it outside. Suppose I have one bowl. This is empty. Okay, I just put up this coin in this. So if you look at this coin from some particular angle, you are not able to see the coin. But let if I just put up the water, I fill the bowl with the water, then after filling the bowl, then you will see the coin. The coin will be visible to you. So it is again the refraction of light. Okay, so one more thing I will do for you people, that suppose I have, this is a solution of water in the oil. Solution of water in the oil. So one layer is for oil, one layer is for water. And if I put up this rod in this solution, if you carefully observe, then the rod will be visible in the water, but it's not visible in the oil. So rod will appears to be disappear in the oil, but it seems to appear in the water. So it's a concept of the refractive index. Due to the same refractive index, the glass rod seems not to be visible to you people when it put in the oil. So you can understand the concept of refractive index by this activity. Okay, then I will do one more thing. Again, I will take some water and I will put some water. I will take glass and put some water in this. And let I put some drop of Dettol solution. Okay, so I just put up a very small drop of Dettol in the solution like this. So very small amount is required, not very large amount is required. And suppose this is a laser light, okay. And if I put up the solution, if I put up the laser light through the solution, if you carefully observe the path of light, the light is not going outside. So it is just bending inside the solution. You can easily see the path of the light as it goes from interface to the downwards. So this is, I am just putting up the light on the interface. So entire light is going the downward direction. So this is a new phenomena for you people, called as total internal reflection of light. That is, the light totally reflects. When you put up the light, you incident the light from some denser medium to rarer medium. So this phenomena is called as total internal reflection of light. So the sparkling of diamond is also based upon this phenomena, that is total internal reflection of light. So now one more interesting activities for you people again. So this is a laser ray box. Are you visible? See. So this is emitting the parallel rays of light, all the parallel rays of light. So this is specially designed laser ray box which emits a parallel beam of light like this. This is a parallel beam of light. Now I have different shape lens with me. I have different shape lens. Like you are already aware of different spherical lenses. See, If I put this, this is a converging action. Very much focus upon this, very amazing activity, interesting activity. So all the light beams get focused at a single point. This point is called as focus. So it's a very amazing activity. You can understand the concept of the spherical lenses like this. Interesting patterns are there actually. So this is a converging action. And also I have different shape lenses with me. Okay, see again, this is a D-shaped lens. So little bit converging action, but quite different patterns are there, like this. Interesting. Okay, and one more. See, this is cutting out some particular rays from particular direction. So this is the different phenomena. You can, amazing laser patterns you can observe in these activities. So different type of lenses you can use for these patterns, like this, again, see, like this. So interesting parameters. Okay. So these are again some more activities, the functioning of the spherical lenses. So here, so these are some few examples. I hope you better understand the functioning of the phenomena of the refraction of light through these activities. Thank you.